Hello everybody, welcome to the class Hydroelectric Power Plants or Hydroelectric Projects. How electricity is produced from the dam, how water stored at a very high level or head can convert the potential energy to kinetic energy and ultimately to electrical energy. That is the problem here and the answer. Hydroelectric power plants convert the potential energy of water stored at a high level in the reservoir for the generation of electrical energy. In the hydroelectric power station, water pressure head is created by constructing a dam across a river. So what happens is water stored at a height is having high potential energy, and while passing the pressure water at a high potential is emerging through the pipe, is converted to the pressure water. High potential energy, and while passing the pressure water through the head or the height of fall of water is converted into high kinetic energy of fast downflowing water. With vigorous energy, that water is flowing down. This kinetic energy is utilized to drive the water turbines. It will rotate at a faster rate, coupled to alternators to generate electrical power. If there is high average rainfall per year in the large catchment areas for the reservoir, which can store large quantity of water at a sufficient head, that is water head in the dam, it will be suitable site for hydroelectric project. So hydroelectric projects are selected. Site for hydroelectric project is cited in such a way that there is high average rainfall per year, large catchment areas for the reservoir, large quantity of water is available, and there is sufficient water head in the dam. All these things are suitable for hydroelectric project. The quantity of power generating from the hydroelectric project depends on the quantity of water available in the reservoir, the rate at which water is available, and the water head, that what is pressure, water pressure head created by constructing the dam. These are the factors to be considered while constructing hydroelectric project. Now, from the hydroelectric project, the electrical power P generated is calculated from the equation. You can read the equation there. What is the equation? Equation is P is equal to Q H eta times 9.081 times 10 to the power of minus 3 kilowatt, and that is the quantity or the power P, quantity of power P generated during the operation. That quantity is generated during the operation, where P is the power generated in the hydroelectric project. Small w is the specific weight of water in kilogram per meter cube. Q is the rate of flow of, Q will be the rate of flow of water. Q is the rate of flow of water in meter cube per second. That is cubic meter per second. H is equal to height of fall of water or the head in meter. H is measured in the meters, so much meters height. And eta is the generation efficiency of this entire project. Now, using this, what will be the power generated from a hydroelectric project? We will have a problem in the next class and method of solving the problem in the next class. We just remember the equation, that is P is equal to WQH eta times 9.081 times 10 raised to minus 3 kilowatt. And we can convert into kilowatt hour also as a unit of electricity. So, in the next class, we will have numerical problem related to this power generated. And P is the power generated in the hydroelectric project, W is the specific weight of the water in cubic kilogram per meter cube or cubic meter, Q is the rate of flow of water in cubic meter per second, and H, height of fall of water or the head in meters, eta is generation efficiency. Now, to conclude this today's class, we will have a discussion on what are the advantages and disadvantages of hydroelectric power plants. The advantages are many and interesting. First one is, the plant need no fuel at all. Entire fuel is supplied or the water at a height having maximum potential energy is utilized for running the turbines. Plant need no fuel. Second is, can run up and synchronized in few seconds, spontaneous process. Number three, have no standby loss, nothing to lose there. The fourth is, it's environmental friendly, neat, reliable, cheapest in operation and maintenance. To suggest there are some disadvantages, they are reservoir. One, reservoir may submerge large areas and the underwater, just like the Silent Valley project or some other projects. Second one is, dry season will affect power supply. There is no water means no power also. No kinetic or potential energy and the turbine will not run. So, water is essential for that. Rain is required. Okay. Now, third one is, high construction cost. Many years required for the erection of this project or dam site for the hydroelectric project. And last one is, the large land area required and long transmission lines are required, because it will be some interior part the dam will be, and in order to supply that current we require long transmission lines. Let us conclude today's class. Thank you for listening. If you find this video useful, do subscribe. Thank you again. Bye.